Titanic was called the Ship of Dreams. And it was. It really was.
All right, open your eyes.
Got everything I need right here with me. I figure life's a gift, and I don't intend on wasting it. You never know what hand you're gonna get dealt next. You learn to take life as it comes at you.
When the ship docks, I'm getting off with you.
You're the most amazingly astounding, wonderful girl, woman that I've ever known. I'm not an idiot. I know how the world works. But I'm too involved now. You jump, I jump, remember?
Every night in my dreams, I see you, I feel you. That is how I know you. Far across the distance and spaces between us, you have come to show.
I may have been one of the last people in the world to see the film, to pay to go to the movies to see the film, the Titanic. Okay? I was like one of five people in the theater at the time. I figured, time came, I gotta see the movie. Everybody else seen the movie three times, I should at least see it once. So I'm there watching it, there it goes, fine. Much about this movie, to remind you, was widely marketed as having precisely captured the details of the ship. Because Jim Cameron, the director, hired this submersible, went down, found the ship, okay, looked at the designs of the wall sconces and the china patterns and the staterooms, captured all of that in his movie. So here's somebody who cares about detail. I'm going to hold him accountable. So, watching the movie, okay? The ship sinks. Sorry, I gave away the... Sorry. In case anybody out there didn't know. We know the day, the time, the longitude, the latitude, the date, the year. We know everything about how, when, and where that ship sank. Okay? There's Kate Winslet on the plank, singing deliriously. There she is, looking up. There is only one sky she should have been looking at. And it was the wrong sky.
Is there anyone alive out there? Can anyone hear me?
Worse than that, it was not only the wrong sky, the left half of the sky was a mirror reflection of the right half of the sky. So it was not only wrong, it was lazy. And I'm thinking, this is wrong. Because I know this, we know this, you that own stuff like this, you know the sky. Right, you know the sky. You know that you, the sky is your backyard. If it's not, it should be. And for a couple of dollars, you can buy a planetarium program on your computer, check out the sky when the Titanic sank. It was not Jim Cameron's sky. So, I pulled out my finest of letterhead. The one that has all the degrees and all the titles. I wrote a letter to Jim Cameron, politely saying, how could you mess up the sky? Got no reply. No reply. 5 years later, I'm on a committee. I'm on a committee that intersects a committee that he's on. He was an advisor to NASA for a while, by the way. Not about the sky, about other things. About exploration, okay? He's a big explorer, by the way. And so, I'm in the room with him. I said, here's the big chance. So I said, Mr. Cameron, I wrote a letter to you some years ago. He never got it. I said, did you know that your sky was just wrong? And we know what that sky was. And everything else about your movie was so accurate. And he says, I didn't know that. I didn't know. In fact, that happened in post-production. And so, and that was all he said. And I was just completely immature about it. I wanted him to grovel for forgiveness at my feet. But he didn't do that. And so, somehow I was deeply unsatisfied by this. 3 years after that, he gets an award from Wired Magazine. They rent out our planetarium to give it to him. Now he's in my place, all right? So in my irrational immaturity, I bring the subject up again. All right, it turns out I was invited to a dinner with him after that event. There were only 8 of us, he and a few of his friends. The wine is pouring, we're all kind of chilling. So I said, here we go. I said, Jim, because now I can call him Jim. Jim. I wrote you, this story will end, I promise, very shortly. I said, I wrote you a letter about the sky and that you didn't get it right. And I, why? How could you do that? And he answered. He said, well, last I checked, Titanic worldwide has grossed $1.3 billion. Imagine how much more it would have grossed had I gotten the sky correct. I couldn't leave well enough alone. That just shut me up. I said, I can't follow that. I can't, nothing I can do. So I went home, tail between my legs. 2 months later, I get a phone call from some guy. I forgot his name. Some guy called me up. Say, hello. I said, hello. He said, I work post-production in Jim Cameron's studios. He's releasing a 10-year anniversary director's cut of the movie, and he's adding new footage, and he tells me you have a sky he can use. I say yes! It is possible to influence these things, as what was the case then and there. But otherwise, I don't cry about it because you just get really annoying to the people who sit next to you in the theater.